And now we take you live to KTEX.
Oh, I'm sorry. I was just browsing. But please carry on with whatever you... Is that the right time? Yes? I don't know what's the matter with this watch. Excuse me for a moment.
Speaking to you from Love Field, where the President's plane has just touched down and is taxiing toward us across the tarmac. We understand the President plans to speak...
Dearest Marina, today I end my life so that your life can begin. Last night... I'm sorry, is that your note?
Fuck you!
We seem to have gotten off on the wrong foot here. It's my fault, I shouldn't have just bothered. You're not going, are you? Well, come on, I didn't mean to... Alec.
What did you call me?
Alec. You used to like that nickname back in Minsk. Marina said Lee sounded Chinese, so she called you Alec. Of course, I don't have to call you Alec, I just
thought... How do you know what Marina called me?
I know lots about you, Lee. Let's see. Born New Orleans, October 18, 1939. Father Robert died before your birth. Crazy mother, Marguerite. Dropped out of school at 17, joined the Marines. Court-martialed twice. Defected to the Soviet Union, October 1959. Defected back, June 1962. Married Marina Nikolaevna. Two children, June and Rachel. Current employment, stock boy. Takes a school book depository, Dallas, Texas. Oh, and this morning, depressed over your estrangement from a wife who views you as a dismal and pathetic failure, you rose before dawn, kissed your sleeping children, put your last $100 and your wedding ring into a demitasse cup, which Marina's mother gave you for a wedding present, and came here to kill yourself.
Who are you?
I'm your friend, Lee.
I don't have any friends.
Yes, you do. You just haven't met them yet.
Show me your badge.
A what?
You bastards think you're so smart. I know my rights. You try to interrogate me at my place of business, I can sue you for harassment.
Ah, you think I'm with the FBI?
I have a right to see your badge.
Search me, Lee. You think I got a badge? Come on, search me. The FBI. You really love those morons, don't you? Hell, why wouldn't you? No one else cares if you live or die. Those guys can't get enough of you. How was your day, Lee? Sell any secrets to the Soviets? Sabotage any defense plants? Kick off your shoes. Tell us all about
it. Fuck you, whoever you are.
I'm sorry, Lee. It's just so sad. I mean, it's all you ever wanted, isn't it? Someone who won't leave you alone. Someone who wants to hear about your day. Someone, anyone. Your mother, Mother Russia, the Marines, your wife, Marina. Attention must be paid.
What's that mean?
It's from a play. About a salesman. A man very much like you, Lee. Independent, proud. A decent man who tries and tries but never gets a break. So he does something dumb. When things go really sour, when he realizes that his whole life has been a failure built on lies, he kills himself. And when he's dead, his wife stands at his grave and says, attention must be paid. She has to beg the world to pay attention to this poor, misguided nobody. Tell you something, Lee, I'm an actor, and I'm a good one. But Willie Loman is a part that I could never play. And I don't think that you should play it either.
I don't know what you're talking about.
What do you want, Lee?
You know so much, why don't you tell me?
You want what everybody wants. To be appreciated, to be valued, to be in other people's thoughts, for them to think of you and smile. You want somebody to love you, Lee, right? Isn't that it? Lee?
Yes.
Forget it.
What?
It's never gonna happen. It's a fantasy, you got to give it up.
I'm going to kill myself. Don't you think I've given it up?
No, I think you're going to kill yourself because you think that's how to get it. When I'm dead, then they'll be sorry. When I'm dead, they'll know how much they love me. When you close your eyes, you probably see the funeral, don't you, Lee? A gentle rain is falling. Everybody has umbrellas.
Shut up.
There's Marina weeping quietly, a sobbing children clutching at her skirt. Your mom, your dad, every boss who ever fired you.
Shut the fuck up!
Sorry, Lee. It's just so childish. It's so dumb.
You think it's dumb? If I shouldn't kill myself, then what should I do? Go home? Beg her to take me back? Plead with her? Beat her up?
You tried all that. It doesn't work.
I know it doesn't work, so tell me what I should do.
You should kill the President of the United States.
What?
His plane landed at the airport 15 minutes ago. He's coming into town to make a speech. His motorcade is going to go right past this window. When it does, you shoot him.
You're nuts.
Maybe I am, so what?
I didn't come here to shoot the President.
He didn't come here to get shot. All your life, you've been a victim, Lee. A victim of indifference and neglect. of your mother's scorn, your wife's contempt, of Soviet stupidity, American injustice. You finally had enough. So how are you planning to get even? By becoming your own victim.
I am not a murderer.
Who said you were?
You just said I should kill the president.
Lee, when you kill a president, it isn't murder. Murder is a tawdry little crime. It's born of greed or lust or liquor. Adulterers and shopkeepers get murdered. But when a president gets killed, when Julius Caesar got killed, he was assassinated. And the man who did it...
Brutus.
Ah, you know his name? Brutus assassinated Caesar, what, 2,000 years ago? And he is a high school dropout with a $1.25 an hour job in Dallas, Texas, who knows who he was. And they say fame is fleeting.
This is stupid, up here on the sixth floor. What would I do, throw school books at him?
What's in the package?
What package?
The package that you brought to work. What's in it?
Curtain rods.
You sure?
Sure, I'm sure. Marina wanted me to take them.
That's a Mannlicher Carcano, 6.5 millimeter. Stopping range 900 yards. The sight's already been adjusted.
Who are you?
My name is John Wilkes Booth, Lee.
John Wilkes Booth shot Abraham Lincoln.
Attention has been paid. All your life you wanted to be part of something, Lee. You're finally going to get your wish.
What is this?
The past you never had. The future you'd abandoned. It's called history, Lee.
My name is Charles Guiteau. I assassinated President James Garfield.
Leon Czolgosz, William McKinley.
Sam Bick, I'm going to try to kill Dick Nixon.
John Hinckley, Ronald Reagan.
Lynette Fromm.
Sarah Jane Moore. Gerald Ford.
Zangara, FDR.
I don't get this.
It's simple, Lee.
You're going to bring us back.
And make us possible.
We're in your debt, old boy.
This bud's for you, babe.
Bravo!
Yes, Lee. Yes. What's he doing?
Getting the hell out of here.
No.
You mean he's not going to do anything?
Lee, I know things are happening kind of fast here, but you can't leave now.
No, watch me.
No, you have a responsibility here, Lee.
To who? To you?
Yes. Yes.
I'm responsible to me and to no one else.
Not anymore, Lee. 50 years from now, they'll still be arguing about the grassy knoll, the mafia, some Cuban crouched behind a stockade fence. But this... right here, right now. This is the real conspiracy, and you're a part of it.
Get out of my way.
Listen to me, Lee. You have to do this now. You won't get another chance.
So? So what? So I'll do something else. I'll shoot my wife. I'll shoot my kids. I won't shoot anyone. Who cares?
He wants to know who cares. I care, you stupid fool. We all care. Haven't you been listening, for Christ's sake? Are you such a vapid, vacuous nonentity? Sorry. I'm sorry. John.
Yes, sir.
John, when Lee was 8, he had a dog. What was its name?
Tex.
The Marine sent him to radar school where?
The Naval Air Station, Jacksonville, Florida.
The KGB official who debriefed him in the Kremlin. What was his name and rank?
Lieutenant Colonel Boris Kutsov.
Lee, 18 years from now, when John tries to assassinate President Reagan, they're going to search his room. And you know what they're going to find? Every book about you ever written.
Can I have your autograph?
Take a look, Lee. Do you know what that is outside that window? That's America. The land where any kid can grow up to be president. The shining city, Lee. It shines so bright you have to shade your eyes. But in here, this is America too. The mass of men lead lives of quiet desperation. An American said that, and he was right. But there are no lives of quiet desperation here. Desperation, yes, but quiet? I don't think so. Not today. Today we are going to make a joyful noise. This is the big one. You're the big one. You're the one that's going to sum it all up and blow it all wide open. Why, after you.
Tell him. Should I tell him?
What the hell? Is Artie Bremmer here tonight? Where's Artie Bremmer?
It was a bum rap. My penis made me do it.
Who's next? Who else is out there?
Death to the enemies of Palestine.
Of course, of course. See your hands, see your hands. And James Earl Ray.
Yeehaw!
Why do these rednecks always have three names? James Earl Ray, John Wilkes Booth,
Lee Harvey Oswald.
I've seen the future, Lee, and you are it.
And now the motorcade is turning onto Elm Street. There's someone holding up a banner, all the way with JFK. The president is smiling and waving as his car heads for Dealey Plaza, where it will swing past the Texas Book Depository.
People will hate me.
They'll hate you with a passion, Lee. Imagine people having passionate feelings about Lee Harvey Oswald. Somebody, help me.
Per favore, la supplico.
Please, I beseech you.
Viviamo senza speranza.
We are the hopeless ones.
The lost ones.
We live our lives in exile.
Expatriates in our own country.
We drift from birth to death despairing.
Inconsolable.
But through you and your act, we dare to hope.
Through you and your act, we are revived and given meaning.
Our lives, our acts are given meaning.
Our frustrations fall away.
Our fondest dreams come true.
Today we are reborn through you.
We need you, Lee.
Without you, we're just footnotes in a history book.
Disappointed office seeker.
Deranged immigrant.
Vainglorious actor.
Without you, we're a bunch of freaks.
With you, we're a force of history.
We become immortal.
Finally, we belong.
To one another.
To the nations.
To the ages.
Bring us together, babe.
You think you can't connect? Connect to us.
You think you're powerless? Empower us.
It's in your grasp, Lee. All you have to do is move your little finger.